Yo, what's good, y'all? Welcome back to the channel, man. Make sure y'all hit that subscribe button if you're new. And if you're old, hey, share with your friends, share with your family, any hooper that you know of, man. We're going to continue to keep on growing. Honestly, I really appreciate all of y'all's support, man. And we're only going to continue to keep going up. So, and also, make sure to turn on post notifications, man, because sometimes YouTube just be bugging. And you'll probably miss an upload or two from me. And it's not my fault, it's YouTube's fault, because they don't be sending out that, hey, JP posted the video. Make sure to turn on post notifications, man, so you'll be the first one to check out my new latest videos. So for this video, I'm gonna be talking about, should you jump up and down or should you use the sweep and sway? So for any of y'all that don't know about the sweep and sway, I talk about it a lot on my channel. The sweep and sway is a shooting technique that most of the great shooters use. Whenever they're shooting for far distances, man, their feet sweep forward while their back naturally goes back. And it's natural. When I say naturally, that means it happens on its own. You don't force your back like that. It naturally falls back. And I'm just saying the answer now, it's okay to do both. So let me explain myself. Let me say the truth about things. Myself, I've always been told, hey, you should never jump up and down in your shot. You're gonna gain tension in your shoulders and it's gonna feel uncomfortable. It's not gonna be good on your shot, which is true, but it's okay to jump up and down if you're close to the rim, or maybe from the high school three-point line, or maybe if you're strong enough, maybe from the college three-point line. You know, it all depends on the player and their strength. Like myself, I'm a little bit older than some of you guys, so that's why I might jump up and down on the high school three-point line, but some of y'all might sweep and sway because y'all a little more weaker. Not to put y'all down, but it's just facts, you know? So we're all different, man, when it comes to strength. So myself, I used to sweep and sway all the time, man. So if I was in the mid-range game, I'll sweep and sway. High school, I'll sweep and sway. But I was like, man, I feel like when I shoot, I feel like I'm putting too much power in my shot, man. How can I change this? So I thought to myself, okay, I feel like I have too much arc in my shot. It's going long every time I miss. I'm like, okay, let me try to jump up and down. Even though I know it's probably not good, but let me try it. I tried it out, man, and I've been doing it ever since, man, and it feels good. Jumping up and down for myself, I do that whenever I'm close to the rim or maybe free throw line and even the high school three-point line, maybe even college sometimes. But do I do that whenever I'm far from the basket? Not at all. Because the further you get away from the basket, the more power, arc, range that you need, because it's further away than a high school or a mid-range game. So whenever I use the sweep and sway, that's when I use more power and arc in my shot, and that gives me more power to get my shot towards the rim. So yeah, so jumping up and down is not bad, bro. It's just something, I guess you'll have to, let's say, you'll have to try it yourself. And depending on the range, man, if you're smaller and a little more weaker, you will use the sweep and sway maybe around the mid-range game and even the high school line, which is okay because remember, we're all different. So if you're strong enough, I suggest, yeah, go ahead and jump up and down in your shot. I'll say it's okay because it's less motion, because when the sweep and sway, you gotta sweep your feet forward, your back goes back. But if you're shooting like a stationary shot, up and down, all you have to do is jump up and down, jump up, release, and then you come down, which is less motion of a sweep and sway. When you have to sweep your feet forward, your back goes back, less of a motion. So I'll say it's okay to jump up and down in your jump shot, but if you're young, feel free, please use a sweep and sway. It will give you range, it will give you arc, it will give you power on your shot. And notice how off the dribble many players use the sweep and sway. Say off of a step back, they'll step back and notice how their feet sweep forward and their back naturally falls back. Like a player like Steph Curry, you got Luka Doncic, you got many other players, man, just watch them. Like even Kemba Walker, the best players use the sweep and sway. But if you also know this, man, like they don't always use it. They use it whenever they need to. So if they're farther away from the basket, that's when they use the sweep and sway. But if they're close, notice how they basically jump up and down. So just to clarify things, man, I've always said you should never jump up and down in your jump shot, and I'm bringing it to you now. Hey, it's okay to jump up and down in your jump shot, but you got to know when to do it. Now, I don't mean you got to know when to do it, like, oh, it's a science or whatever. No, it's very simple, man. Like, if you're a shorter player, you might have to sweep and sway at the mid-range game. Or if you're a stronger player, you won't even have to use the sweep and sway around the mid-range game. You could probably just jump up and down, like I do myself. For myself, I jump up and down for the mid-range game, high school line, college line. But whenever I get further back, let's say NBA or beyond, that's when I'll use the sweep and sway. I just spit all on my dashboard. Yeah, what was I saying? I just went blank. Yeah, so like, the further you are from the basket, that's when the sweep and sway will be more effective, because it'll give you more power that you need. So if you're a strong player and you use the sweep and sway, let's say by the free throw line, you might miss hella shots long, because why? You're putting too much power in the shot, and you're adding an extra motion to your shot, which you don't need. You can just jump up and down, very simple, and make more shots. So it depends all about the strength, man. But feel free, man. If you feel like you're strong enough to jump up and down in your shot from, like, let's say mid-range game or high school, feel free. But if you're kind of smaller and weaker, please go ahead and use the sweep and sway. It will help you out, man. That's how you gain power and more range on your shot. The sweep and sway helps you, man. And remember, the sweep and sway is whenever a player, their feet sweep forward and their back naturally falls back. Naturally. Yeah, that's pretty much it for the video, man. I hope y'all enjoyed the video. Right now it's 9:43. I'm about to head to the barber real quick to get me a fresh cut, because I need it bad. I've been holding it off so long. I got my braids done like an hour ago. Looking fresh, man. But now I got to get that fresh fade. But I hope y'all enjoyed the video, man. Make sure to tune in next time for whenever I post. Turn on post notifications. Make sure to go follow me on my social medias, my Instagram, my Twitter. Please follow me, man. Just continue to grow those as well, man. And I will see y'all in the next video. JB Gang up in here. Till next time. Let's get it.